The Adventures of Super Toilet Part 2, Deja Poo. Yes, Super Toilet, striking fear into the thought of evil poo everywhere. With his faithful companions, Driplette and Soapy Hero, they form the Super Hygiene Team. Our story begins in the Antarctica, where they are teaching local kids about sanitation.
It's an ice toilet called an igloo.
But suddenly there is an ominous sound.
Hello? Oh, it's so sanitary here. Disgusting.
Oh no, it's Dr. Pooh.
The Super Hygiene Team? I must put an end to Super Toilet. Oh, that's good.
P.U., what happened?
Dr. Pooh must have gone back in time and erased hygiene out of existence. We must stop him. Quickly, back to Drain Manor.
Cool toilet.
It's a time portal potty. We can use it to scan through the history of hygiene.
Yay!
Let's start at the very beginning. In caveman times, they just used a hole in the ground. A hole in the ground is fine as long as it's away from drinking water.
Hey, Barney, what is that, a wheel?
Oh, no, it's a toilet seat.
Hey, look, a hole in the ground.
The Egyptians used clay pipes for plumbing and boiled water to purify it. The pyramids were actually giant restrooms for the corporate elite.
Ramses, let my people go.
Ah, ancient Rome. The Romans built sewers for latrines and aqueducts for clean water. They even used soap invented by the ancient Babylonians. But during the Dark Ages, it all plunged into the gutter. People used chamber pots and flung the water into the streets. That's why it was called the Dark Ages. It lasted for 1,000 years. Okay, hygiene is making a comeback. Slow it down and stop! Sir John Harrington and the Queen of England.
Oh, hello, visitors. I was just testing out Sir John's new invention.
Yes, Mother. A toilet is a way to cleanse and keep sweet the noblest part of ourselves. And don't forget the royal flush.
Cheeky!
Ha 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 ha! Aha! The first modern flushing toilet. I will crush this Game of Thrones with my sonic poo driver.
Stop that villain from ruining my invention!
Oh, put a lid on it, Johnny.
Oh, good idea!
You are out of time, Dr. Poo.
Oh!
That's my job every day, sending poo on its way.
That was the most beautiful flush I ever saw. Thanks, great-great-great-great-grandpa.
But Dr. Poo got away.
He's gonna try to stop hygiene another way.
Before the 17th century, people didn't know germs existed. See, there's Leeuwenhoek with his microscope discovering germs in water.
It's 1847. Stop here. I want to meet my homeboy and make something clear. Semmelweis was rapping about hygiene, teaching hand washing, keeping it clean.
Wash your hands after you do your duty and keep away those nasty cooties. Yeah, I mean yo.
But where is Dr. Pooh?
He's probably going after clean drinking water now.
I know when. The Great Stink. Fast forward to London, 1850. See, Dr. Snow was trying to figure out why there was an outbreak of cholera centered around Broad Street. The problem was that raw sewage was leaking into drinking water.
The horror.
Stop! Look at what has been making them sick!
Eliminate! Eliminate!
Recognizing the problem is only half the battle. If nobody takes action, Dr. Pooh wins.
I will overthrow hygiene by staging a poo.
Let's flush to the scene.
Ew!
What is causing that horrible stink? Let's get out of here! It's too late to stop me, Super Toilet.
It's about time, it's about space. Time we put this poo in its place.
Clean water.
Hygiene.
And sanitation. Work together for a healthy population.
I'm gonna scrub you out, see?
Oh dear!
Garde loo, Dr. Pooh!
Fire in the hole!
Hey,
Get me out of here!
Evil poo running rampant can be a real pain. That's why it's important to keep poo contained.
Thank you, Super Hygiene Team. We will get to work on new sewers right away.
Let's go home.
Everything is back to normal.
But our work here is not done yet. There's still 700 million people without safe drinking water and 2.5 billion people without a decent toilet. We've got to get the word out about hygiene.
Super Hygiene Team, you've got to come with me back to the future!
What, did Evil Poo take over?
No. In 2030, everyone has access to clean water and toilets. It's the other planets. We've got to do something about them!